on the northeast tip of North America, on an island called Newfoundland, there's an airport. It used to be one of the biggest airports in the world, and next to it is a town called Gander. Welcome to the rack if you come from away. Huh? You probably understand about a half of what we say. Yeah. They say no man's an island, but an island makes a man.
Especially when one comes from one like Newfoundland. Welcome to the rock.
That morning, I'm in the classroom. It's our first day back, and the school buses are on strike, so I'm covering for Annette, who's running late.
Sorry, Beulah. How's the kids?
Not exactly thrilled to be inside on such a gorgeous day. So I told them we'd only have a half day this morning, and they were quite pleased, until I told them we'd have the other half in the afternoon.
Welcome to the wildest weather that you've ever heard of,
where everyone is nicer, but it's never nice above.
Welcome to the farthest place you'll get from Disneyland.
Fish and chips and shipwrecks.
This is Newfoundland. Welcome to the rock. An islander, I am an islander.
Kids cross Airport Boulevard to get to school, and that time of day, people are in a little bit of a rush to get to work and stuff. So, normally, I sit there and run my radar.
Whoop, whoop.
And if they're speeding, I'll stop them and write out a warning ticket. I'll write STFD. Slow the fuck down.
Welcome to the land where the winter strikes to kill us, and we said,
we will not be killed.
Welcome to the land where the water strikes to drown us, and we said,
we will not be drowned.
Welcome to the land where we lost our loved ones, and we said,
we will still go on.
Welcome to the land where the wind tried to blow,
and we said no.
That morning I drop my kids off at school and head to the SPCA, where I'm greeted by my other kids, all barking and meowing for breakfast and a belly rub. Not that I'm complaining, I love them. But by the time feeding is done, I got to get back to pick up my human kids. So I take just 1 second for myself, and I'm sitting in my car.
I'm in the library.
I'm in the staff room.
And I turn on the radio.
You are here at the start of a moment, on the edge of the world, where the river meets the sea. Here on the edge of the Atlantic, on an island in between there and here.
I'm running my radar when Bonnie comes by. She pulls up and she is waving at me like mad. So I roll down my window and she says,
Oz, turn on the radio.
Slow it down.
Jesus H. Oz, yeah. Turn on your radio.
Where our story starts.
It's my first day at the station.
Where we'll end the night.
I'm getting coffee for the picket line.
Where we know by heart.
5 minutes to my smoke break.
Every single flight.
I'm off to work at the airport.
Welcome to the park. Welcome to the trees. To the ocean and the sky and whatever's in between. To the ones who've left, you never truly gone. Our candles in the window and the candles always on. When the sun is coming up and the world is coming short. If you're hoping for a harbor, then you'll find an open door. In the winter from the water, through whatever's in the way. To the ones who have come from away. Welcome to the rock.
On final approach, we're coming into runway 22, and I think, where am I gonna park this thing? There are planes lined up like sardines, and as far as I can see, there's cars lined up too. It looks like everybody in Newfoundland is here.
One plane, then another, and then another, and then another.
Is this on?
And
sorry, I'm new.
Planes,
this is Rogers TV, Channel 9. My name's Janice Mosher, and I'm reporting live from Gander Airport, where the 19th plane has just touched down. I'm here with
Bonnie Harris. On a normal day, we get a half dozen flights. Now, we already got three times that many landing in 2 hours. That's a lot of noise. You can smell the fuel. You can smell the exhaust.
Jesus, that's a jumbo. There's got to be 250 or 300 on her. That's a fairly large one. There's got to be 200 on her. Now I'm adding this up. We got 38 planes. We got 200-300 people on the average.
38 planes.
Holy shit.
11:53 a.m.
Tuesday,
September 11th, 2001. Any available community buildings will be converted into shelters. With thousands of passengers arriving at any minute, the town is asking for help with, well, anything you can do.
Crystallize on
for blankets and bed and maybe some food.
Do you know what they need and how much?
I need something to do, cause I can't watch the news anymore.
Can I help? Is there something I need to do? Something to keep me from thinking of all of those scenes on the tube?
I need something to do, cause I can't watch the news.
No, I can't watch the news anymore.
In the winter, from the water through the wind, if a stranger ends up at your door,
you get on a horn. Hello, this is Beulah Davis down at the Academy. I heard we might be getting some guests, and I thought I'd see if I could help who's ever in charge of getting the school organized. How many passengers can we take? Well, we fit about 400 students. Yes, we could probably do 600. Yeah, or sure, 700 if we really pack them in. When are they coming? Could be any time now. Well, I'm glad I phoned.
I get a call from Beulah, looking for anything 700 people from around the world might need. So I go down to Shoppers, and the manager says to just take what I want off the shelves. Toothbrushes, floss, mouthwash, deodorant, and I'm back at the school when Beulah says,
you know those planes probably got some babies on them.
So I'm back to Shoppers for diapers, and we're unpacking them when Annette says,
you know those babies are probably gonna be hungry.
So I'm back to Shoppers for formula and baby food, and when I get back, Beulah says,
you know those planes are probably filled with women of childbearing age.
So
I'm back to Shoppers to pick up as many pads and tampons as they have.
The Baptist Church needs a hand moving their pews. Dr. O'Brien down at the pharmacy is ready to fill any prescriptions. Oh, and the Lions Club is looking for some toilet paper if you have any extra.
Medicine,
toothpaste,
underwear,
aspirin,
jackets our kids grew out of last summer.
And down at the station we're taking donations out by the door.
Holy Jesus, there's more!
It's better than being at home alone wondering what's really happening. Everyone's phoning.
We're setting up rooms in the school.
And it's crying all afternoon wondering what can be done.
What do we need?
I made a tray of sandwiches.
We need 50 more.
Sandwiches?
Trays!
What do we need?
200 gym mats, is that enough?
You tell me and we'll both know.
What do we need?
For the love of God, stop bringing toilet paper to the Lions Club.
How do you know what you need when you don't know how many you're needing to feed? When you don't know how many are staying, how long they are staying? We better start praying the weather stays nice.
In the winter from the water, in the winter from the water, in the winter from the water,
in the winter from the water,
if a stranger ends up sent by fate.
Are we going to be ready?
Well, we have to be, don't we?
When you include the original flight, we were on the plane for probably 12, 13 hours.
We were on there 15 hours.
20 hours.
28 hours. We were on the plane for over an entire day.
28 hours, over an entire day. There was one aisle in the middle. Everyone knew every inch of that plane.
We're allowed out of our seats, but not off the plane.
You never think about it, but airplane doors are 20 feet in the air.
And even if you survived the jump, they probably would have shot you.
You could go up to first class, you could stretch in the aisles.
They had three seats on each side, there was only one aisle in the middle.
Everyone knew every inch of that plane.
Our flight was full, there were children sleeping on the floor.
We had no way to get information.
This is before most people had mobile phones, and only a couple people got through.
Hello? Mom. Bonjour. Operator.
Tom. Oh, thank God. I finally got through. I borrowed a passenger's phone. How are you? Are the kids okay? No, I'm fine, Tom. I'm fine. Safe and sound on the ground here in Newfoundland. We don't know much except for the BBC. Listen, I can't talk long. Can you do something for me?
I'm okay. I'm fine.
Oui, bien.
Pick up.
Tell the kids I'm all right. Take them into the kitchen and show them the map that we used to put pins in for each destination that we flew together. Tell them I'm put a pin here in Gander.
On our plane, someone has a cell phone,
but then the battery dies.
There are phones in the backs of the seats,
but they don't work.
Half the passengers on our plane don't speak English.
Even if we knew what what was happening. We don't speak their language.
On our plane, we asked the flight attendant.
But the captain says not to say too much, and that's when rumors start flying. There was an accident.
An accident?
The U.S. airspace is closed.
For the first time in history.
Why won't she tell us what's
happening? The helicopter crashed in Pennsylvania.
The helicopter crashed.
Ma'am, I need to
wake up. We need to do something.
It's 1-4-3. Oh, my God. It's 1-4-3.
Plane, we didn't have a clue. We were all going insane because
there wasn't squat to do.
Then the captain starts apologizing, says on behalf of the airline, I'm giving each and every one some
complimentary booze. Open the airplane doors, wave at all the cars. Hello to whoever you are, wherever we are.
The ground crew supplied whatever we needed.
Nicotine patches,
medication,
pampers,
something to drink.
So the flight attendants brought out mini bottles of liquor and delivered them to everyone.
Soon everyone got friendlier.
I took a couple of pictures of the view there with my camera. We didn't know where we were,
but we knew that we were hammered. Open the airway doors, wave at all the locals. Show me there's something better to do than park wherever we are.
We've been sitting there for 14 hours when we pull out the Grey Goose.
Kevin and I were kind of hiding it because
well, we didn't want to share it. Anyway, this woman, this hot mess behind us, kept completely freaking out.
I don't understand why they can't let us off. I mean, just to stretch our legs? I mean, really? I need to get some air. Oh my God, I need to get off this plane.
And my boyfriend Kevin, we're both named Kevin. It was cute for a while. Anyway, Kevin was not dealing with it well.
I'm going to kill her.
Excuse me? I would like to get off the plane. I am claustrophobic.
Excuse me. Like some Xanax, because you are freaking out, and it is freaking me out, and we are all freaking the fuck out.
Open the airplane doors, let a little air in here, cause I can use a shower or a bar, or a bar. Open the airplane doors, look at all the planes out there, there must be a convention, it's bizarre.
Keep telling us nothing's wrong, but I've got kids, and I've got grandkids. I know when someone's hiding something, and when parents need their kids to stop asking questions, they start playing movies.
We ran through every movie we had, Legally Blonde, Dr. Dolittle 2, and Titanic.
I sit here. I need to get some work done. And there's some drunk people at the back of the plane singing at the top of their lungs.
No, of course. I'm Diane.
Nick, how you doing?
I'm worried about someone. He was flying today. I just wish there was some way to tell him where I am.
Newfoundland. Oh, no, you know that. You just can't tell him. Right. I'm hoping you're one of those people who laughs when English people say awkward things.
I just wish we knew what was happening.
What's happening?
What's happening?
Somewhere in between
your life
and your work.
When the world may be falling apart
and you think I'm alone.
I'm alone and I'm so damn helpless.
There's nothing left to do but drink.
We open the airplane.
I'm up in the cockpit with some of the other passengers when the pilot puts the radio on over the intercom and the whole plane goes silent when the president gives his speech.
I ask the American people to join me in saying a thanks for all the folks who've been fighting hard to rescue our fellow citizens and to join me in saying a prayer for the victims and their families. The resolve of our great nation is being tested, but make no mistake, we will show the world that we will pass this test. God bless.
You got through to the airline. Tom, I'm okay. Tell me what's happening out there. How bad is it? Tell me everything. Tom, who was in the air? No, no, I wouldn't have known them. No, no one on that airline. Charles, are you sure? No, I'm fine, Tom. I'm fine.
We can see them from the plane. This long line of headlights coming through the darkness.
Ladies and gentlemen, you can take only your carry-on items. Check luggage will remain in the hold.
The captain and flight attendants tell everyone to take their blankets and pillows off the plane.
Out of the window.
We grab bottles of water, too. No one has any idea where they're taking us.
Darkness and trees.
As we enter the airport, all those car lights are still aimed at us.
We're scared. They're probably scared, too.
The people here don't know what to expect off of these planes.
The airport looks like something left over from the Cold War, and Kevin's like,
oh my God, we've gone back in time?
The whole procedure, the soldiers, and all the formality, it just makes me really nervous.
There's a giant map on the wall of the airport, and someone has written in red marker, you are here.
Excuse me, I need to find a phone. I need to call my son.
I'm sorry, the payphones are out of order.
They're all lined up at the airport payphones, so eventually we put an out-of-order sign on them, just so we can get people on the buses.
11:48 p.m. Buses and drivers are now taking passengers to shelters, not just in Gander, but also to Campbell, Appleton, and farther communities of Lewisport, Norris Arm, and Glenwood.
Our bus sits there forever.
While all the others leave.
Finally, this other passenger gets on.
This guy from the Middle East.
Someone says he got questioned.
Someone says he got searched.
And now, he's on our bus.
I tried to interview the Red Cross, the Salvation Army, but they got more important things to do than to talk to me. That's when I see them. The plane people through the bus windows. The terror on their faces. They have no idea where they're going. They take me and my crew in a separate van, and I'm looking out the window trying to see where we are, but it is pitch dark. Now, I have flown over this area hundreds and hundreds of times, and it is just darkness. Hardly any lights anywhere. And now here I am. Oh my God. This is just so remote.
Into the darkness.
Stars and no sunlight.
Look all around us.
Nothing but darkness.
Out of the window.
Into the darkness.
Darkness and
every school bus we got is going back and forth all night. Out to the Salvation Army camp, we've delivered passengers from Germany, England, and France. And around 3 in the morning, my bus is designated to take out these African people out there.
My family and I try to see out the bus windows. No one tells us where we are going.
Silence comes on the bus. We get outside a gander and you could hear a pin drop.
My wife and daughter are scared. They ask me what is happening. And I do not know.
Behind me, this big man comes up to me. And he says in this low voice,
Wewe watochukua wapi?
What's that now?
Climb aboard!
Hop right in, me ducky.
Let's get you where you're going.
You've all seen the airport. Used to be the biggest airport in North America. Planes used to stop here to gas up from everywhere.
Oh, Frank Sinatra, Albert Einstein.
Muhammad Ali,
the Queen.
Then they invented jet planes that can get across the ocean on one tank.
So there's no need to refuel anymore.
Leaving us with this giant airport.
Now there's the reason I drive slow.
That there in the middle of the road?
Yeah, that's a moose.
She'll move when she's good and ready.
Mind if I sit here?
Oh, hello, Nick. I thought we'd lost you.
No, I just needed to get an emergency prescription filled. Nothing serious. It's not like, oh my God, he's off his medication. I'll stop talking now.
It's fine.
Any news yet about your husband who was flying today?
No. Do you mind if we just don't talk about that? I haven't been able to get to a phone.
I'm sorry. I'll help you find a phone as soon as we get wherever we're going.
Finally, out of the darkness, my bus arrives at the Salvation Army camp.
We pass through a large gate and a bus pulls to a stop. And through the windows, out there in the darkness, we see all these people coming out of the buildings.
The flying one does.
We rarely hardly use them, but everyone's dusted off their Salvation Army uniforms to welcome these people.
There are soldiers everywhere.
And there's over to CC.
The man at the front opens the door.
I say, here you are, out you go. But he doesn't understand. And he's not getting off. None of them are.
He's on a meeting.
But then I notice his wife, well, she's clutching a Bible. Obviously, I can't read it, but their Bible. It'll have the same number system ours does, so I ask to see it, and I'm searching for something. And then, in Philippians 4:6, I give them their Bible, and I'm pointing, saying, look, Philippians 4:6, be anxious for nothing. Be anxious for nothing. And that's how we started speaking the same language.
Katia Gisa, out of the darkness, salvation and brightness, God is equal, everything changes, and I see to me. Katia Gisa, out of the darkness, God is equal, God.
Welcome to Gander Academy. I'm going to show you now to your rooms, and then if you want to come back, we've got two TVs set up in the cafeteria with the news on, so you can see what's actually happened for yourself.
I didn't even think. They haven't seen any of it yet.
Lead us out of the darkness.
We're all staring at those images.
And we just stand helpless watching them.
Lead us somewhere to safety.
We barely know where we are. We know it's not there.
Lead us far from disaster.
Charles Burlingham was the captain of Flight 77 that crashed into the Pentagon. I just saw him at a pub in London. You can't imagine. A pilot will fight to the ends of the earth to save his airplane. He just will.
Lead us out of the night.
We watched those images for hours. Until someone finally turns it off.
1:15 a.m.
Wednesday,
September 12th. Crisis counselors are called to Gander Academy.
The plane people? They're exhausted, but they don't want to sleep. And we're standing there ready with all that food, but that's not what they wanted. They wanted phones.
1:45 a.m. Six phones are put on tables for the plane people to use free of charge, lined up alongside a road by the Newtel building.
An hour later, they set up 20 more phones.
An hour after that, there are 75 phones and computers with internet all being used round the clock.
Hello? Yes, it's me.
Dad, I'm okay. It's okay.
I'm calling from Canada.
Safe and sound on the ground here in Iceland.
No, Newfoundland.
Yeah.
We just saw the news.
Have you heard yet from Kev?
Or Selena?
Call Micah.
And Lauren?
My parents.
My aunt.
It's Diane. No, I'm fine. Where's David? Oh, thank God.
3:45 a.m. Overnight, the community's population has gone from approximately 9,000 to 16,000. I'm sure barely any of us have slept tonight. We're hopeful that our visitors will be back in the air come morning.
I woke up from this dream, which I can't quite remember, but there was this music in it that I'd heard somewhere before.
I woke up from a dream that we were stuck in some backwater Canadian town and that my air mattress deflated.
I woke up to the smell of freshly baked bread.
4 a.m. in Newfoundland is breakfast time in Germany, and we got a lot of passengers here from Frankfurt, so breakfast starts at 4 a.m. and we start scrambling eggs.
Poached eggs, scrambled eggs, omelets.
Fried bologna.
Something called Tautens.
I saw a casserole dish I don't think I could lift.
They made enough food to feed 7,000 people. It's like they never slept.
There's this one man from the Middle East. Well, we don't really know. Hasn't said a word to a soul, and some of the other passengers seem a bit wary of him, so it's a little odd to find him poking around a kitchen.
Oh, hello.
Hello, can I help you with something?
I would like to be of assistance with the food.
Oh, no, that's not necessary. Really, you go out there and sit down.
I've been going all night, but I can't stop. None of us can. I splash some cold water on my face and just keep going. We've got 7,000 scared and angry people who don't want to be here, and they're about to wake up.
In a crowded room filled with strangers sleeping,
an airplane blanket and pillow on the floor,
the sun comes streaming through the window,
and I can't sleep anymore.
Staring at these strangers waking up around me,
sitting in a crowd of people waiting for the phone,
and in a town that's suddenly doubled population,
I feel so alone.
It's like any of us could have died on Tuesday,
and like we're dared to see things differently today.
I'm feeling different, distant,
strange.
Who are these people here?
Where am I? No one knows me here.
Who am I if I don't feel like the me from yesterday?
I wake up in a crowded room full of people sleeping on the floor, and I see Diane and ask, are we leaving?
Anytime now.
Is your hair different? I mean, you look good. I like it.
Thank you. No shampoo for 3 days.
They start handing out clothes to anyone who needs them.
I haven't changed my clothes in 39 hours.
I wanted to burn my socks.
Kevin puts on this plaid thing. He says he's incognito and that he's going to blend in with the natives. But he just looks like a gay lumberjack.
Changing into another woman's donated set of clothes.
Looking different, feeling kinda different too.
I can't quite explain,
but when I woke,
when David wasn't on that plane,
it's like I changed into somebody else, but who? And it's somehow like we're at a costume party,
and for a second you are not yourself.
You are not yourself.
And you look around and blink your eyes,
and barely even recognize
the person in the mirror who's turned into someone else.
Hey, little sister. Yeah, still here where they eat rainbows for breakfast. Are you taking care of Mom? No, I just wish I was home. No, not L.A., Brooklyn. Shut up, you're such a brat. No, I just needed to hear your voice.
Excuse me, are you Hannah?
Yeah, that's me.
My name's Beulah. Someone told me your son's a firefighter, and mine is too, here in town. And I know Gander's not New York, but is there anything I can do?
No! I just need to hear from my son.
I understand.
Praying for a phone call.
Praying for a way home. Asking questions, asking, can I get back on that godforsaken plane?
And all around me people chat.
And people snap
like nothing's happened. And I need to hear we're going back before I go insane.
Good morning, I'm Captain Bass. I've just heard from the airline. Now, I know this is going to be hard to hear, but the American airspace remains closed. I can't tell you how long we'll be on the ground, but we are going to be here for some time.
Here for some time.
Here for some time.
Here for too long.
Here for how long?
When will we know how much longer?
Beulah, wait. Can you help me find a Catholic church?
I can't sit here. I need to get some air.
Let's go see where we are. The sun's out. It'll do you good.
Seriously? You know what? Go get lost in the woods. I'm going to be ready when we leave.
And it's somehow like we're stuck here at a messed up costume party.
And there's nothing here familiar.
Far away from those you care for on an isolated island in between.
Set up, labeling anything that'll go bad with the date and time. I let the pants out for one of the pilots who's been enjoying our cooking. Make a balloon animal for a crying toddler. And then I check on Hannah, leaving messages for anyone she can reach.
I am here. I am here on an island. Hello? Hello? It's me again. Yeah, my son. He's with Rescue 2. Any news? I am his mother. I'm far away, stuck here. I'm trying to find out if... Fine, I'll hold again.
I should be down there and checking the hospitals, putting up signs, doing something instead.
I am here. I am here in Canada. I am telling you, listen, my son, he takes risks. He's not missing. He's helping or hurt. He'll get out of this. Yes, I'll keep trying. And yes, here's the number. And yes, at the Legion in Gander, I'll be right here. I should be there. my son, but instead I am here. I am here.
She leaves message after message for her son, until there's no more room on his answering machine.
All I know is you are there.
Me to church, and when we get there, I light a candle for my son.
And I do too.
I suddenly realized what that music was from my dream. It was an old hymn from when I was a kid. I haven't been to church in years, but for some reason, that song was in my head.
Make me a channel of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me bring your love. Where there is injury, your pardon, Lord. And where there's doubt, true faith in you.
Make me a channel of your peace.
Make me a channel of your peace.
Where there's despair in life,
where there's despair in life, let me bring
hope. Where there is darkness, only light.
Where there is darkness, only light.
And where there's sadness, ever
shalom. Say shalom aleinu, fe'al kol Yisrael, fe'imru, amen.
There's a man here in town. He's lived here nearly his entire life. He heard that there was a rabbi diverted here, and he came to find me and tell me his story.
I was born in Poland, I think, and my parents, they were Jews. They sent me here before the war started. I still remember some of the prayers they taught me. As a boy, I was told I should never tell anyone I was Jewish, even my wife. But after what happened on Tuesday, so many stories, gah, just like that. I needed to tell someone.
During El Fagir, when most people are asleep, it is easier to pray. But at Duhur, I can feel them watching me. Sometimes I catch them when they think I'm not looking, and I can see the fear in their eyes.
Excuse me, Beulah wanted me to check on you. The library's open for anyone looking for some peace and a quiet place to pray.
Yaseh shalom, yaseh shalom, shalom aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael. Yaseh shalom, yaseh shalom.
Darkness, only light, and where there's sadness, ever joy.
Some people spend their days crammed inside, shoulder to shoulder, with nothing to do but watch the news and wait for something to happen.
On the edge!
We got the TVs going 24-7 in the cafeteria, and the more they watch, the more scared and angry they get.
On the edge of the...
Some of the plain people haven't slept in 3 days. None of us have either. And we're jumping at our own shadows.
On the edge of the world!
Around supper time on Thursday, people are waiting to use the phones, and there's a fight in the hallway.
Hey,
what the hell are you saying?
I beg your pardon.
You celebrating this? You praying for your friends? Why
don't
they speak English?
Excuse me.
Are you telling your Muslim friends what a bomb next?
This was not all Muslims.
And that was not where you came from.
I'm Muslim and I was born in Connecticut.
All right, everyone,
I'm an American citizen.
You don't look American.
What does that even mean?
On the edge of the world or wherever we are on the edge. Is there something I need to do? Something to keep me from thinking of all of those scenes on the tube? I need something to do because I can't watch the news. No, I can't watch the news anymore. On the edge.
The FAA keeps delaying opening the airspace. And here on the ground, we're dealing with a whole mess of other problems.
On the edge of the...
Some of the planes are parked on a runway where the surface is all torn up. That debris gets into an engine and they'll never leave.
On the edge of the world.
One of the big planes, the 777, is sinking into the asphalt. If we don't do something, she'll be stuck here forever.
On the edge of the world or wherever we are on the edge.
I interview a woman from Queens, a mother. Her son's a firefighter and they still can't account for him. She starts crying and I start crying too and I can't stop shaking. I don't want to do this anymore.
I check in with air traffic control again, and it's more bad news. Not only is the airspace still closed, but there's a storm headed for Newfoundland. Hurricane Erin is making landfall tomorrow or the day after. If we don't get these planes in the air soon, no one's going anywhere.
God, people are starting to crack.
Let's get everyone down to the Legion.
Everyone's going down to the Legion for a drink.
Hi, have you seen my boyfriend? His name is Kevin. He's about this tall and he's lost his mind.
I just want to go out.
Well, I don't.
Well, I'm not going without you.
Well, I'm not staying for a long time.
One drink.
Hannah, everyone's going out tonight?
You go on without me, Beulah. I need to wait by the phone.
I'll wait with you. I keep waiting to hear from the airline, so I'll just be here by the phone, Tom, if the kids want to speak with me.
Bonnie, I know you're not leaving the animals, so I brought you some chili. But I really think that tonight you should come home and get some sleep.
Doug! Oh my, get in here! We are about to have the first rare bonobo chimpanzee born in Newfoundland!
Beulah, they need some food down to Legion, if you can spare any.
Miss Beulah, please let me help with the food.
No, my love, you're a guest!
Please, I am a master chef for an international hotel chain. I oversee restaurants around the world. I would like to help with the food.
Get in there! Everyone's going out to the bar, and Nick is going.
I'm going if Diane is going.
And I think, nobody here knows me. I can be whoever I want to be.
I'm not worried about my wallet. I'm not worried about getting shot. I am a little worried about how much Irish whiskey I'm drinking.
By 8 o'clock, the bar is completely packed with people from around the world. Everybody's talking about where they're staying, what they've seen, and the bar staff keep making runs for more beer and liquor. After an hour, people are swimming in the river out back. And no one brought their swim trunks. A couple of luckabies get up with their accordions and fiddles, and someone brings out an ugly stick.
Farewell to all you pretty ladies waving from the dock. Heave away! Me Johnny's heave away. And if we do return to you, we'll make your cradles rock. Heave away, me Johnny Pies, we're all bound.
Farewell to Newfoundland, and bye to leaving us alone. Heave away, me Johnny's heave away. And if you find another, we got lovers of our own.
Heave away, me Johnny Pies, we're all bound away.
And then we get the karaoke going. Ceremony.
Let's make these people honorary Newfoundlanders! Now there's a solemn old tradition for admission or audition to transition from a come from away
to be a Newfoundlander.
The only other way, at any rate, is pass away and pray to fate and wait to reincarnate.
As a Newfoundlander, hey, come on inside. Nothing ventured, nothing tried.
Only a couple of people cried.
You be a Newfoundlander, hey, sit down right here.
Trying to ignore your doubts and fears.
And you'll be a Newfoundlander.
Now we need a couple of volunteers. Who wants to become a Newfoundlander?
Right here!
Good man! Who else?
I have no idea why I put up my hand in Kevin's life.
Oh my God, are you serious? Oh my God, you are serious.
Yes, I'm serious. Don't do it if you don't want to.
I won't.
Where are you from, buddy?
Los Angeles.
LA! Who else?
Us! We want to be Newfoundlanders!
All
right. Where are you folks from?
Texas.
Texas. What part of Texas you from, buddy?
No, I'm not.
I'm from Texas. He's from England.
Wait. Now, how does that work?
How does what work?
Well, how does your marriage work with you being in England, her in Texas?
We're not married.
I'm sorry. I assumed you were married.
No.
Well, would you like to be?
Well, why not?
Diana had two beers by then, so it was probably the alcohol talking.
I've never had more than one beer at a time before, so it's probably the alcohol talking.
I went and got her two more beers.
Now, the first part is the easiest. We'll soon get to the queasiest. I'll need you to repeat this mess.
When you become a Newfoundlander.
God, it speaks a different language, son. We add some S's and some rum. You'll have to try a good cat talk.
When you become a Newfoundlander. Hey, hey, soon you're dressed. Nothing scary, nothing yet.
Change the way you're dressed.
And you'll be a Newfoundlander. Hey, hey, to sing along. Not adventure, just prolong.
There's 30 verses in this song.
And you'll be a Newfoundlander.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Screech. Back in World War II, an officer was stationed here and was offered some of this stuff. All the locals were tossing it back with our quiver, so he does too. And let's up to near Pearson. Everybody comes to see what's happening, son.
What was that ungodly screech?
And now it's your turn. Are you ready?
No, good.
All together now. One, two, three. Down the hatch.
Screech is basically bad Jamaican rum.
Screech is horrific.
Screech is delicious.
And then they brought the cod.
The cod.
The cod.
The cod.
Now with every transformation comes a tiny bit of risk. Gotta walk the plank and there'll be blood or there'll be bliss. And it's a shame to be a Newfoundlander. Every person's weird, so don't be down, just take the plunge. Go on, kiss the fish. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a genuine, freshly caught Newfoundland cock. And if you want to become an honorary Newfoundlander, you'll have to give her a smooch. What?
If you kiss that, I am never kissing you again.
I'll risk it.
I'm not kissing a fish.
Come on. I will if you will.
Oh, my God. Fine. Three.
I can't do it.
What? I just did.
Now, you gotta kiss the cod. It's a vital part of the ceremony.
I can't do it.
All right, look. I'll make you a deal. Either you kiss this fish or else you kiss this Englishman that you're not married to.
Hey, hey, come on tonight. Take a risk and take a ride. Jump right in, we'll both be tied and you'll be a Newfoundlander. Hey.
Told him that I'd be a pilot. But I was too young and too short, and there were no female captains. And my dad said, be patient. He said, just see what happens. But I took my first lesson, came down from the sky, and told my father I'd fly for the rest of my life. And I got my first job, flying for a mortician in a tiny bonanza, just a corpse and me. $5 an hour for flying dead bodies. I had climb over their faces just to get to my seat. Then suddenly the wheels lift off, the ground is falling backwards. I am suddenly alive. Suddenly I'm in the cockpit. Suddenly everything's changed. Suddenly I'm not too young or too short, and the passengers in don't complain. Suddenly I'm so I applied as a flight engineer. But the World War II pilots, they all complained. They said girls shouldn't be in the cockpit. Hey lady, hey baby, hey, why don't you grab us a drink? And the flight attendants weren't my friends back then. And they said, are you better than us, do you think? American captain in history. Suddenly I'm in the cockpit. Suddenly I've got my wings. Suddenly all of those pilots protested me. Well, they can get their own drinks. Suddenly there's no one saying stay grounded.
To stay close to our shelter so we're ready to go again. So we end up on one last walk to this gorgeous lookout, the Dover Fault.
There's about a million stairs.
It's beautiful. Nick, you gotta see this.
Wow.
I can't believe we're here.
I know.
I can't believe we're leaving.
I don't want to go.
What did you say?
Oh, I don't know. I'm gonna get a picture or two.
Oh, okay.
Stop the world. Take a picture, try to capture, to ensure this moment lasts. We're still in it, but in a minute, that's the limit, and this present will be past. So here we are, where the world has come together. So here she'll be in this picture forever.
Look at this. 540 million years ago, the continents of the world crashed together right here. And 200 million years ago, they separated again, moving apart from each other.
Huh.
But a little part of them was left behind. I should move. You're missing all the scenery.
No, no, no. Stay where you are.
Really?
Really. It's perfect.
Stop the world. Seize the moment. He goes, you're alone, and it's through. Pinch yourself, tell yourself you're just dreaming. That means he'll forget about you. But here we are, where the continents once crashed together. Before they went their separate ways forever. So stop the world.
Stop the world.
Stop the world.
Stop the world.
Stop the world
from spinning round. I'm on a lookout, overlooking something worth taking the time to stop. Flying by and look down, stop being scared.
picture of the scenery, of a lookout, of a moment which is over, of the ocean, of the river, of the trees. Stop the world, please.
The winds start to pick up. 50-mile-an-hour winds. We have been here too long. We're still on the ground. There's a hurricane coming, and I'm thinking we're running out of time. We have to leave. We have to leave now.
Everyone, I am sorry saying goodbye. So I wanted to thank them for all that they did. So I'm doing just that, and I'm passing a hat for the people who gave up their time and they gave up their town. So let's give them a scholarship. Pass the hat down.
I want to say something, but we're leaving and it's over.
And then she starts crying and I don't know what to say. So I just put my arm around her and I go to kiss her on the forehead to comfort her.
Well, there was some turbulence and honestly, I just thought he missed. So I...
Ladies and gentlemen, if you look out your windows, you won't want to miss this. We just entered Texas.
In the back.
At one point, a flight attendant comes round saying,
hot towel, cold towel.
Somewhere in between the pace of life and work and where you're going, something makes you stop and notice, and you're finally in the moment.
As soon as I get back.
And then she left.
And then I was alone.
Back to the way that things were.
back to the simple and plain.
For 5 days the weather had been so nice,
but as they boarded, it started to rain. At the end of the day, after everyone left,
we all tried to go back to normal, except
the town was more quiet and somehow far emptier.
We all looked the same, but we're different than we were.
The gym was a sight as I stacked the last cat.
Thank yous written everywhere and things they forgot.
The Board of Health says clean it up every part.
So we start
7:42 a.m.
Sunday,
September 16th. After 5 days, they just ran the Zamboni over the ice and played hockey. With the plain people gone, Gander Town Council declares a state of emergency over, and I head home. We were all exhausted, just spent. Most of us have been up for 5 days straight working. But somehow I can't sleep, so I sit down, turn on the television, and I just start crying. I hadn't let myself cry the whole time.
Something's gone.
Out the airplane window, I can see Manhattan, and there's still smoke. And suddenly, I'm afraid all over again, and there are others afraid too.
Something's over.
I know Newark Airport. You could pull a truck over on the side of the turnpike and shoot a grenade launcher at a plane coming in.
Something's done.
But nothing happens.
I drive Kevin back to his place. We don't say much.
Something's missing.
I go straight to his firehouse. Part of me wondered if they just weren't telling me, but they still don't know.
Something's changed.
My flat is the same as I left it, but empty, quiet. I start to unpack, and I find the camera.
Something's rearranged.
On the way to my restaurant, I drop my daughter at school, but she won't go in. She says she's scared. What do I tell her?
Something strange.
Back at my dad's house, I look out the window at this view. I've looked at my whole life, and now a part of it, something's missing.
Something's missing.
Kevin breaks up with me, and then he quits and moves back home to New York, and I miss him. This is jokes.
Something's lost.
Nick and I call each other when we can, but it's awful. The only reason we met was because this terrible thing happened.
Something's cost.
I go down to ground zero, which is like the end of the world. It's literally still burning. Were you okay? How were you stranded? How do I tell him that I wasn't just okay? I was so much better.
Something's missing.
I phone American and say I'm ready to go, wherever you want to send me, but they say take a few days off. I phone every day and I am back in the airport by Thursday, and it's empty. Silent. It's just a different place. And I stop what few passengers there are, and I say thank you for still flying.
Hello, you've reached Gander Academy. This is Beulah Davis. How can I help you?
He's gone. It's over.
Oh, no. I'm so sorry, Hannah. I'm so sorry.
You are here at the end of a moment, at the end of the world.
In an airport, in my house,
on an island,
in a classroom,
at the station,
in my car.
And wherever you are, somewhere, you are
here. I'm reporting live from Newfoundland for BBC.
CBC.
CTV.
Al Jazeera.
For Rogers TV, I'm Janice Mosher. On September 11th,
2011,
the town is again filled with come-from-aways. On the 10th anniversary, from all around the world, we welcome back the Plain People.
One, two.
One, two, three, four.
Welcome to the friends who have come from away. Welcome to the locals who have always said they'd stay. If you're coming from Toledo or you're coming from Taipei, because we come from everywhere,
we all come from away. Welcome to the right, an islander, I am an islander, I'm an islander.
Meant to be, but nothing goes as planned.
And the drunkest fellas in the room are playing in the band.
Welcome to the rock.
With all the new security, kids aren't even allowed up into the cockpit anymore. Of course, on my retirement flight, I brought my whole family into the cockpit on our way back to Gander.
I came back with the scholarship money we raised, now worth over $1 million.
I bring out the Irish whiskey and we have ourselves a toast.
Nick and I just couldn't make the long-distance relationship work.
So I moved to Texas, and then I proposed.
And we honeymooned in Newfoundland.
My new secretary's name is Robin.
What's up?
Every year on September 11th, I close my office and give each employee $100 to go and do random good deeds for strangers. It's my way of remembering what happened.
Buell and I still keep in touch. She even came to visit me in New York. And I'll still phone her if I hear a really stupid joke. Beulah, why are Newfoundlanders terrible at knock-knock jokes?
I don't know, Hannah.
We'll try it. I'll be a Newfoundlander.
Knock-knock.
Come on in. The door's open.
The donation we are most honored by just arrived today.
It's about 4 meters long and 1,200 kilograms.
Newfoundland is the only place outside the United States where we share the steel from the World Trade Center.
On the northeast tip of North America, on an island called Newfoundland, there's an airport. And next to it is a town called Gander. Tonight, we honor what was lost, but we also commemorate what we found.
Welcome to the rock!